Way up internet. So today I'm going to be taking on a renewable energy project, but there is a reason why I'm doing this. Now, every year Shell run what's called their Eco Marathon. Now, this is a competition for university students and clever people alike, and they set various challenges like trying to get cars to run from London to Rome just using a litre of fuel. But this is 2020, you ain't running no events this year, are you? But they've not just given up, they've come up with a new event called Pitch the Future, which is where old Furze comes in, because it's an online event and I'm hosting it. So, those same students get to pitch their ideas in from these wonderful four categories. Now, these are real world issues like trying to make your house more efficient, your deliveries more efficient, and your batteries in your car more effective. So I thought if I'm talking to these people in this wonderful competition, I should probably have a crack at one of these categories myself. So what's the plan then, Furze? So I've chosen the category decarbonising the home because I am at home and this is my idea. I'm going to make a wind-powered clothes drying machine. Stay with me, stay with me. Now the brief of this category is to make the home more efficient without losing our creature comforts. And a tumble dryer is very much that creature comfort. You put your washing in the basket, you stuff it in, it gets dry, bosh. Now a washing line, which you could already argue is a wind-powered clothes drying machine, you have to physically hang it all up. As humans, we are past doing that, no. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to get the pole that the 360 swing is on. We're going to mount a wind turbine on it. The shaft's going to come down. It's going to turn a big drum of clothes, which can naturally dry inside of it. Oh, it's going to be magic. Right, I need to get myself some sort of drum to put the clothes in. Fine example of a machine. Right, let's get the drum out. Right, that's got it out. It's second hand, of course, so it's a bit manky in the back. Now, I was looking at it thinking, it's not really very big, is it, Colin? Now, of course, if it's an actual tumble dryer and you're pumping hot air through it, that doesn't really matter. But if I shove a load of wet clothes in there and then just turn it round, it's not going to dry very quick. They're kind of insulating themselves. And obviously, that's the beauty of a washing line, is they're all flapping around in their own space. So Colin's looking at this thinking, you need to be a lot bigger so it tumbles it a lot more. So I think I'm going to have to do away with this and make me own. So that was a complete waste of time. Kind of circular. Welcome to Pitch the Future, where even the chairs move. Got the tumbly bit, a lot bigger, nicer, I like it. Now, I've got a few things to do with it. I'm going to take these starry bits off. It's strong enough, it doesn't need that. Then it needs some sides and it needs probably a bit of a back on it, because at the moment the clothes are all half falling out and they're all going to get tangled up in the mechanism. Now, we need to make this spin, of course, from a wind turbine. I'm going to put this gearbox thing on the back of the shaft, at the back there, have another shaft go up to a spinny wind thing. Yes, and I think I'm going to do an upright wind turbine so we don't have to have another one of these, because the more gears, pulleys and connections you have, energy losses, my friend. We do not want energy losses, not in this system. No, bit more of that. Look at that, look. Just need a giant mouse now, don't I? You ain't got one, not got it.
Distance.
It's all connected. There's a little bit of rolling resistance. I may have over-engineered it slightly and put too many bearings on, but at least it ain't going to fall to bits. Spinny washing, decarbonisation, home comforts, yes! This will not be a chocolate fire guard. We cannot let it be that. Massive. Right, let's see if we could hang it up, if it works.
Just the moment of truth. But it's up. We've got no wind.
Okay, got some MA in focus. Yes, it was. We got a wind turbine. It does spin round when it's windy. Now then, made my adaptions to the washing drum, strengthened it up. Added a bit of perspex. Also done the same sort of thing around the back with a bit of plywood. Oh, very nice there, Colin. Now, of course, we're going to attach this to our shaft and it's going to spin round. But I hear you say, Colin, if it rains, all your clothes are going to get wet and therefore ruin your clothes drying process. So what we're going to do, well, it's not what we're going to do. I've already done it. I've made this look. Oh, yeah. Look at this. So, that can go in there, like that. That can spin round in there, and it won't get wet anymore. That's good, so we can just come in, shove the clothes in. They can be in there for hours tumbling around. They'll get dry. Now, to aid that, we've got a solar panel up here, haven't we, Colin? Yes, that is going to be powering this van. Van? It's a fan, Colin. We're going to shove that in the drum somehow, so it can kind of, you know, really, really get the air in there circulating, really help dry the clothes off better. And then the only other problem we've got is, of course, if it's not blowing any wind, the drum's not going to be turning around, and we're just going to be blowing air at a load of wet clothes sat in the bottom of a very nice cylinder. This renewable energy malarkey is pretty tricky, isn't it? Kind of makes you appreciate what the engineering students have got on their hands with this competition. Right, let's go and get it mounted. Okay, we've got no wind again, but it's perfect sunny day. This is perfect drying clothes weather. So then, what I'm thinking we're doing, I've done a little bit of maths. That solar panel will run that fan for 10 hours at least. If it's sunny, it'll technically keep it going forever because the panel is powerful enough to feed the fan, you know, just constantly on its own without the battery being involved. So, we've got power in abundance, we've got power to spare. So what I'm thinking is we'll stick a motor on the back of it, so when it's not windy, it can be motor driven, and of course when it is windy, it'll be wind assisted, basically. So that is what we're gonna do. Now that's kind of quite complicated, but it's all right, I have a plan.
Ooh.
Right, this is my motor setup. Now this is slightly more complicated than it looks. There's a few things we don't want to be doing. When we're powering the drum with a motor, we don't want to be turning the wind turbine as well. So there is a one-way bearing set up in a couple of these things, which is basically a bearing that can only spin in one direction. So if you try and spin it the other way, it kind of grips up. So it's a little bit like a clutch. So when the wind turbine turns, look, it will turn this round. It turns the shaft, which turns the drum, very nice, but it doesn't turn the motor look. So we're not driving the motor with the wind. And then equally, when the motor turns on its own, oh yeah, it turns the shaft, but it ain't turning the wind turbine round. That's good, but if the wind turbine want to turn round, it can turn round, it can do what it likes. Right, never mind talking about it. Let's go and fit it on, power it up, and then it doesn't matter if I ain't got a windy day, because I can put this on, can't I? Right, think it's ready for a test.
Now, I've not been able to fully test this properly before uploading the video, because ever since I've finished it, we haven't actually had any wind. But the solar panel does charge the battery up easily, and it will power the fan and the motor for 24 hours, no problems. But what is the drying time, Furs? Now, it's November at the moment, so this is a pretty extreme time of year to test this. On the end of summer, it's going to work a lot better. Now, if you leave the clothes in here all day, they do actually dry, but some of the thicker ones have still got little damp patches in, so I added another curtain to the front of it.
Ooh, snazzy!
Now, what this does, it kind of makes this a bit more of a greenhouse, because you do get heat well up in here from the sun, and basically this just kind of insulates it a little bit more, makes it stay hotter, and that was enough to get rid of all those damp patches in the clothes. Oh, very good, Colin, very good. Now, I know this is kind of a crazy idea, but it does actually work. You know, I can use this. I don't need to use my power sapping tumble dryer anymore. There's a couple of design tweaks it needs to do, because for some reason it seems to spit socks out, and I was looking at it thinking it kind of needs like a little curved bit round here, a little bit like a tumble dryer or washing machine door, which made me thinking, I wonder if that's why they are the shape they are. Rather than so we can just see what's going on inside, it's probably to help cycle the clothes inside so they always get shoved to the back and turn around, eh? The things you learn when you do these things, the things you learn. Actually quite impressed with this as well. Charges the batteries up pretty quick. I could nearly have a secondary lighting circuit in my shed. You know, low powered LEDs, whole thing could run off solar power. Who would have thought this is potentially the future?
Carbon reduction fresh.
There we are, a wind solar powered clothes drying machine. Now, I know it's a little bit slower than a conventional one, and you're clearly not gonna be able to fit that in a kitchen or a utility room, but I have dried my clothes all from renewable energy. That is a win. Now, I've approached this in kind of a low tech, lo-fi way, but if you wanna see some proper high tech stuff, go and watch the live pitches. There's a link in the description. And of course, if you're watching this after that's happened, I'll put another link in the description where you can see everything that's been entered into the competition. Thank you very much. See you all soon.
Smells like renewable clothes drying to me.